Hello everyone, and welcome to another video. In this video, I want to take a look at our Godot XR Tools library. This is part one of a longer series. In this part, we will look at what the XR Tools library is, and how to add it to your project. I'm planning future parts, where we'll take a more in-depth look at each individual feature of the library. We've recently released version 3, which is the version we'll be looking at in this series. This new version is a major refactor over the previous version, and now includes a full demo application that shows off the different features. This demo is what you are currently seeing running in the background. This version of the library supports Godot 3.4, though we'd recommend using the latest stable 3.5 version. Well, at least at the time of making this video. We are working on a Godot 4 port. Much of this tutorial series will be usable in Godot 4. While there are changes in the way Godot 4 handles XR, much of this library works the same. You can download the Godot 3 version of the XR tools directly from Godot's asset library. In the next section, we'll have a look at obtaining the latest version through GitHub, but if you're happy to use the stable release, you can skip this section. As mentioned, the source of the Godot XR Tools library can be found on GitHub. The link can be found in the description below. As with everything else Godot, it is MIT licensed. There are some assets included in the library that are released under CC0. Be sure to check if there are any license updates since the making of this video, in case assets are added that require attribution. If you go to the releases section of the repository, you can find official releases of the XR Tools library. Our current release is 3.0.0, and you can download the release directly from this page. The Godot XR Tools demo zip file contains the full demo project. The Godot XR Tools zip file contains just the XR Tools library. You can also download an alpha version of the Godot 4 XR Tools library. Note that currently the demo in this version is broken, but the XR Tools library itself, for the most part, works. Keep in mind that this is an alpha version, and seeing Godot 4 itself is still in beta, this is far from production ready. The master branch in our repository contains the latest development version of the library, and you can clone it to get access to even newer functionality. Do note that the repository does not include a copy of the OpenXR plugin needed to run the demo. To get started with the XR Tools library, we're going to quickly run through a basic setup. In future videos, we will go into more depth into these and other features of the library. We will be using Godot 3.5 in this tutorial series. Note that we're starting with the demo project I created in my Getting Started with OpenXR video, but without the older version of XR Tools added in. We go to our Asset Library tab at the top of the application. Now we search for XR. Our XR Tools library should be one of the first entries. Simply click on the library, and then click on Download. We don't want the files in the root, so we deselect those, and then click on Install. Next, we go to the project settings. We go to the Plugin tab, and we make sure our plugin is enabled. Note that the plugin by mistake still says Alpha. You can ignore that. The first thing we want to add is our shader cache. We add this to our ARVR camera node. This will trigger Godot to compile shaders used by the XR Tools library. Next, we'll add the hand models that come with the plugin. We have one for each hand. These are different from the models that come with the OpenXR plugin and are guaranteed to work on all platforms. Their offset is currently wrong and you can move them into a better position, but I'm not doing that in this video. The next release of the XR Tools library will have the correct offsets built in. There is also a physics version of each hand scene. We'll look into those in a later video. Next, we'll add some basic locomotion to our scene. I always like to add the teleport function to the left hand, and we simply do this by loading in the teleport function scene. For the teleport function, we need to assign our camera node. In future versions, this may become automatic, as it is for most other functions. We'll configure our right hand for direct movement. This has now been split into multiple scenes, each implementing some form of movement. Today, we will add two, starting with the direct movement function. This allows us to use the joystick to move forwards and backwards, and optionally strafe left and right. If we use strafe, we can't add rotation to the same hand. We do want this, so we also add the turn movement function. This function by default allows the user to turn with the joystick in snap mode. This is a motion sickness preventing measure that makes the player turn in fixed degrees at intervals. You can, however, turn on smooth turning, something we advise leaving as a choice for the end user. Note also that Godot has automatically added another node called player body. This node is used by many of the movement functions. We only know the center of our play space and the location of the player's head. We have no idea where the player's body is, while most of the movement functions require to know this in order to correctly move the player. The logic to infer the location of our player body and to handle the movement of the player's body and apply this movement correctly to the ARVR origin node is all embedded within this node. Now we can run our project in order to see what we can do so far. We can see our hands floating around in front of us. They also react to our trigger and grip sensors. Moving the joystick on my right-hand controller, I can move the player around. Notice the jerky turning when I use the controller compared to the smooth turning when I move my head. By pressing the trigger on my left hand, I engage the teleport function. I can move my left controller around to aim where I want to go, then release the trigger to teleport to that location. I can also use the joystick on the left-hand controller to change my orientation when I reach my destination. And that is where we'll leave this video. I'm planning on making separate videos to take a more in-depth look into each feature the XR Toolkit has to offer. Let me know in the comments what I should cover first. Also, let me know if you want me to do a walkthrough of the demo that comes with XR Tools. As always, if you found this video useful, please leave a like on the video. If you wish to support me more directly, please consider becoming a member of my channel. You can also follow me on Twitter for regular updates, or follow me on Mastodon just in case. See you next time!